My name is Jason Coon. I'm a member of the Church of Christ in Grapevine, Texas. My plan, my dream, my whole life has been to become an evangelist and help in any way I can in spreading the Word of God. In the first half of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, the Bible addresses the day of the Lord, when it will come, how it will come, and what we need to do in preparation for when it comes. Paul explained that we cannot know when this day will come. So, because there's so much at stake on this day, we need to be prepared for it every day. However, to live according to God's word every single day of our life, it's not an easy task. It's one that some are discouraged by, thinking, surely I can't be obedient my whole life. So what's the point in even trying? It's possible that even the brethren, some of the brethren in Thessalonica were thinking the same thing. So Paul, who knew the struggles of the Christian life more than most, didn't end this section of scripture only with instruction, but with a little encouragement as well. This is found in verses 9 through 11 of 1 Thessalonians 5, where it says, "For God did not appoint us to wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him. Therefore, comfort one another and edify each other. Just as you also are doing." There are some words in this translation that could be a little bit better translated from the Greek, such as a point could be a little better translated to place, wrath a little better translated to vengeance, obtain slightly better translated to gain. Through a little bit more of an exhaustive word study, which sadly we don't have time for tonight, the message in this passage becomes a lot more clear. After telling the Thessalonians about the hard task of preparedness that they have to face every single day and that we have to face every single day, he doesn't leave them hanging as to whether or not it's possible. He says, God didn't place us, God didn't put us down here so that he could take vengeance on us. He put us down here so that we could gain salvation through the sacrifice and the suffering of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So that whether we're dead or alive, no matter what's happening, when he comes back, we can live together with him for all eternity. See, God didn't set us up to fail, but to succeed. To say that it's impossible to live the Christian life is to say that God sent his only son to die for absolutely nothing. The message that I want to leave with all of you, and that I want all of us to take into this new year, is that even if there's one person here who feels weighted down with burdens, who feels like the Christian life is too hard to live, who feels that it's impossible to make it through just one more temptation, I want you to know it's not impossible. If it were impossible for you to obey God and to live a Christian life, then you would have never been created in the first place. The very reason we were created was to obey God, Ecclesiastes 12:13. So that through the obedience and through the suffering of our Lord Jesus Christ, we could have an eternal home in heaven. However, God doesn't expect us to be perfect. In fact, the Bible says we can be. That's why he's given us everything we need to live faithfully, including the forgiveness of sins. So that when we do fail to obey him, if we as Christians come to him with a repentant heart, or with a repentant heart, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins, 1 John 1:9. We cannot allow the times that we fail to discourage us to the point where we won't succeed. We must instead take our mistakes, learn from them, repent of them, and with perseverance, get back on the straight and narrow. 1 Corinthians 15:58. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. In closing, I'm not going to stand up here and tell you the Christian life is easy. The Bible says a lot of times that it's not. But it does say even more times that it's well worth it.
Amen.